Champion tennis player Serena Williams was spotted at a local disaster and recovery center on the island of New Providence. All right. Serena Williams has joined forces with the international community, and she has put her money where her mouth is and actually came on the ground to assist with those who are evacuees who presently have been relocated to the island of New Providence. All right, so we would all like to say kudos to Serena Williams, our sister. She heard the cries, she saw the plight of our people, and she responded with a gift. And not just with a gift, she came in person to lend her presence to those who are grief-stricken, all right? And so these types of initiatives and gestures cannot be quantified. The impact will have far-reaching benefits for all of our people, because this gesture sets a trend, sets a precedent for future situations which undoubtedly will occur. All right, and so when catastrophes take place, it will be the humans themselves who actually make a difference. All right. Charity begins at home, but when you see people can reach across the shores, reach across borders, and show solidarity with people who are going through a crisis and who have survived the crisis, family, our gratitude is beyond words, all right? And so we would hope that the true spirit that exists in all humans, which is the spirit of goodwill, tolerance, patience, all right, philanthropy, we would hope that these things would continue to persist on a consistent basis, where our people can look out for each other, all right? And in a political sense, these type of social initiatives are actually frowned upon by cabinets and by Congress members around the world, who look at socialist initiatives as somehow being contrary to progress, all right? But we can see how it is beneficial when we lock arms and we all unify towards the assistance of those who are in need, all right? Now, what I would like to say, you know, I didn't want to say it, but the thing is, it's inescapable, because I've seen situations like this so many times, and I feel like I would be remiss if I didn't comment on it. You know, I am always happy to see when people can assist during the time of a catastrophic event. It warms the heart, it warms the soul. But my thing is, just the day before the storm, right? Just like one day before the storm, people actually passed the homeless people on the street and they wouldn't lend a hand. Some people would pass a person sleeping on a sidewalk and they would just step over him and continue their day. They would see a homeless mother trying to feed her kids and they would make memes and, I guess, comedic portrayals of the plights of other people, you know. I never understood it, but it is something that we need to dispense with. But what I would really like to say regarding that point, I believe that we need to translate the response that we have during crisis to our everyday reality. Okay? We need to do that. We need to actually transpose this mentality, this goodwill. We need to transpose it into our regular everyday activities. Okay? People shouldn't boast only about the things that they acquire. You know, if I was a wealthy person, I would feel good if I could boast that I impacted the lives of a few thousand people, right? If I can go in a county and say, guess what? I ensured that there were no homeless people left in that county, made sure that there were no hungry people left in that county. Pick an island and say, you know what, I'm going to make sure that all of these people in this small village, their homes are sound and they have proper evacuation facilities in place. You know, these are the types of things that I would like to see. But oftentimes, you know, it's disappointing to see that the spirit of goodwill that is in our people after a tornado, after a hurricane, after a tsunami, after an earthquake. You know, it's great to see that we would be so willing to assist people during a catastrophic event, but after the catastrophic event would have faded into memory, there is an indifference that continues to live among us and within us. You know, and I think we need to transpose this good attitude, this good feeling that we have from helping people. We need to transpose it into our everyday reality. Help the next person. All right, donate. All right, donate to charity. You see what I'm saying? Don't wait until you're researching the body count to actually think about helping people. That is, I think, too little, too late. But the need still exists after a storm and after a catastrophe. So, you know, all assistance and all aid is appreciated. You know, but people, let's be realistic and help people when we are in a time of crisis, okay? But let me know your thoughts in the comments below. One love.